Alrighty, my people, another segment now, promoting, featuring, and sharing our talented Jamaicans. Before the break, you heard some of the benefits of journaling. Now, our next guest is a student author who has two publications out. Did he start out journaling? We're going to find out. His name is Quade Thompson. Welcome to Smile Jamaica, Quade.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, you're most welcome. So tell me about you. Where are you from? Where do you go to school?
Well, I'm from the parish of Clarendon. I am now attending the Northern Caribbean University, where I'm pursuing a Bachelor of Arts degree in Communication Studies.
All right. You coming to work with us at TVJ?
Yes, definitely. That would be great.
All right. Come in, man. We're ready for you. Ready for the new generation. All right. Did you start out journaling?
I did, actually. I've always been passionate about writing. I've always been passionate about the English language and dissecting the English literature. Throughout my high school experience, English literature was one of my favorite subjects. You know, I really enjoyed doing that. But I think the real beginning of the journey for me was when I started to attend university. And, you know, at the time I would have been going through a lot of things, you know, a lot of stresses. And so I recognized that writing, specifically poems, you know, was therapeutic. It really helped me through a lot. And that's where the journey really began for me.
Literature is so important, whether it's an e-book or a physical book, a hard copy, which I have two here. Thank you.
Right.
I can't wait to read them. However, and it's a big business too, but how do you get started? You're an entrepreneur, you're an author, you're published. How does it work for those who are listening and would like to join the journey of publishing their own book? How does it work?
Well, firstly, you have to know what you want. You know, you have to know who you're writing to, why you're writing. And once you write a book, you know, there are different processes that you have to go through. So, you know, currently I have on my team members who, individuals who, you know, are dedicated to get the book off the ground, specifically persons like Quinnell Ming, who helped me with the layout of the book. You know, you have to go through the process of acquiring an ISBN, you know, for the book to be legal, you know, because it has to be copyrighted. You know, then the graphic designers design your cover based on what you want, you know, it to look like, because image is everything. And so the cover must be appealing. And so you go through the various processes, you get the book off the ground. I'm a self-published author.
Right.
So I didn't venture into the book market by way of, you know, acquiring a publisher to help me. I had to do most of the work myself, where, you know, sales are concerned, getting persons to, you know, understand the value of the book and why they should purchase. So it's a rather tedious process, but it's definitely worth it.
Excellent. Page 34 of this one, Poetic, Where Power Meets Poetry, by Quade Thompson. Gratitude. Countless are the houses in which families lie still, with pots too clean and cupboards too well kept. For while we slumber in perfect peace, a mother squeals, alone in anguish, with three children to feed. Greed bleeds and needs needing strength, genes needing length. When was the last time you expressed true gratitude? Wow. Nice, short, potent food for thought. And then you see a quote that says, they say that my poetry serves as food for thought, yet they do not dine with me. Well, right. You're saying a lot there, Quade.
A whole lot. Right.
In just a few sentences? I can't wait to get through this book. Who inspires you?
Well, that's a very important question. The truth is, my experiences, as well as the people around me, they are my inspiration. Mm. My experiences, as I mentioned earlier, you know, upon starting university, a lot of persons experience the same struggles, wondering where their next meals are going to come from, how the rent is going to be paid, and of course, you know, the workload is a lot. So there were times when I felt down. And as I mentioned, writing was, you know, the go-to for me. Mm. It helped me to remain calm. It helped me to remain focused. You know, it was therapeutic. It was like a basket that I could, you know, empty my load into, you know, and that made me feel better. And also the persons around me, they inspired me because I realized that writing wasn't just about therapy anymore. It was about advocacy, you know? Mm. So for the persons around me who felt as if they were voiceless, I wanted to be that voice for them. So whenever I wrote for them. You know, for example, there's a piece in Poetic entitled What She Felt, you know, that was a piece that was inspired by, you know, the experiences that a lot of women have, you know, being unappreciated, you know, undervalued by men, feeling used or, you know, taken advantage of. So that was, you know, to express the fact that I understand what they're.
Oh, wow.
I thought we lost about you. That.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sorry. We had a little freeze there in the connection. I thought we lost you, but we have to end it there.
I'm here.
Mr. Poetic. Poetic. Where power meets poetry. Where do we purchase your books? You also have another one, Dear Verotica, which is a more explicit...
Adult-friendly, right?
It's about a relationship between two main characters. This is for the grown folks, people with the red lips there.
That's right.
Dear Verotica and Poetic, which is for the picnic day adults, for everybody. For the family, you can have this one. All right, where do we purchase your books?
It's safe. It's a safe read.
Even Verotica's safe?
Well, my books can be purchased at the NCU bookstore. Well, no, Verotica is for an adult-friendly audience. So definitely would advise against, you know, children reading that book. But it's for, you know, couples who would want to, you know, just digest, you know, that whole vibe. It's for them. It's for them.
All right, lovely. Thank you for my copies. Again, where do we purchase, Student Poet?
Right, so my books can be purchased at the NCU bookstore on Manchester Road or at the A to Z bookshop and Tiny Tots at 27 and 28 shops on Mandeville Plaza. So, yeah.
All right.
Also, persons can send me a direct contact directly at 876-521-5473 or send me a DM on Instagram. The IG handle is already there at poetic_lifestyle.
Congratulations again, Quade Thompson, an author of two books.
Thank you.
Self-published. We are so proud of you and can't wait to see you, as you join the media fraternity and just make us proud as a Jamaican. We wish you all the best. May you have no stress in your life, my brother. Coming up next, people, Quade Thompson, that was. And coming up next, a virtual tea meetup. Yeah, stay with us.